Next on Prep Sports Plus, we find out what it's like to be number one. We hit the diamond in the north and in the south to see what life is like in 5A. Our Academic Athlete of the Week takes on challenges in the classroom and on the field. These titans of the field are our creams of the crop. This celebration for the champs was anything but Little League, and we have highlights from week two of the regular season. Prep Sports Plus is next.
Welcome to Georgia's only statewide high school sports and academics program, Prep Sports Plus, brought to you in part by...
Wachovia helps our customers stay informed about important issues by supporting GPB. We see it as an essential part of our commitment to serve our growing state. With hundreds of financial centers and ATMs in Georgia, Wachovia can help you realize your financial goals.
As a proud sponsor of the Georgia High School Association, Georgia's electric membership corporations provide reliable electricity and service, not only to our communities, but to the athletes within them. Georgia's electric membership corporations, lighting the way.
The Georgia Student Finance Commission. Now students can plan, apply, and pay for colleges in Georgia on one website. GACollege411.org.
And by viewers like you.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to another edition of Prep Sports Plus. I'm John Nelson on deck for the fastest half hour of public television. We kick things off looking at a program on top that looks to stay there. For the longest time, Northside Warner Robins head coach Conrad Nix was always this close to a state title, but never could get one. Now that the Eagles have one, they look for another as everyone looks to knock them off. Our Anthony White checks in on the champs.
It's been a long run for Coach Nix, and he finally will get his first state title at Northside.
Dominating second half performance.
The last time we saw the Northside Eagles, they were celebrating their first state championship in 21 years under Coach Conrad Nix. They finished the season 15-0 and dominated everyone in their path. It feels good to be on top, but that was last year.
Well, it's hard to put in words. Obviously, it's something that you dream about and you work for and all of that. Everybody does, you know, and you're blessed enough to get one, you know, and you feel very thankful. And, you know, it's been a long time coming, but it was certainly the wait was worth it, you know. That was last year, though.
And it was back to business as usual for the Eagles. They lost several key defensive players but returned 10 offensive starters, which should give them a slight edge over the competition. But being the defending champs, it won't be easy.
We knew we had to work, and everybody's gunning for us, so that's how it is for a champion. So you just got to work harder than everybody else again.
We're real focused, trying to get back and do a repeat. We don't want no one knocking us off our title, so, you know, we're going to stay on top of our game.
2 years ago, like, you know, we lost a lot of starters, and then, like, you know, last year we lost a lot of starters. So this year we're still going to pull it together. We all have trust and faith in each other, and, like, you know, as long as we hold hands and, like, you know, be one as a team, we will achieve anything.
Well, last year, the Eagles managed to put up a lot of points on the board with a steady and solid offensive line that protected Ivory and opened up the holes for Tywan Green, allowing him to rush for over 1,700 yards and 23 touchdowns. But get this, 1,000 of those yards were in 5 games in the playoffs. Wow.
I created my O-line for the blocking for me, you know, because they did help, you know, they did help me to get where I need to get over 1,000 yards in the playoffs, you know. But those guys, they hard workers. They the hardest workers on the field.
Tywan's a special guy. He's a guy that really loves the game, and he does a really good job in a lot of areas, and we're proud of him and thankful for him. But, you know, those guys up front, Tywan knows, and he gives them hugs and, you know, love and all. And, you know, it's a thing where, like I said earlier, those guys do well, those guys behind them are going to do well.
So close, but no cigar. It took Coach Nix 21 years to finally bring home the hardware. So I asked Coach, would a second one be much sweeter than the first one?
I don't see that, you know, how it could not be. You know, I don't know how it's going to be because I haven't been there yet. But it'd have to be very, very special.
What was it like to see Coach Nix get that first state championship out of 21 years of coaching?
It was good for him. He was crying. He was a little sensitive a little bit about it. He was crying, you know.
He cried a lot. Tears of joy, though, not tears of being sad or whatever. So.
coach another 21 years of coaching?
I hope 21 more years of living, tell you the truth. You know, it's getting a little bit old, as you can look very well see.
Coach, you look marvelous. Good luck the rest of the season. From Warner Robins, Anthony White, Prep Sports Plus.
Thanks, Anthony. We move from Central Georgia to the West to check in on the sports overtime team from WTVM-TV in Columbus with their look at a Region 2 AAA showdown, Shaw against Carver-Columbus.
I mean, last year, Carver won the regular season game, but Shaw won the state semifinal showdown at the Georgia Dome.
Tonight, Carver and Shaw meet up again at McClung Memorial Stadium. A good one. Shaw fumbling an early kick, and here is the result. Daron Furr into the end zone all by himself. They missed the PAT, 6-0 Carver, but the Raiders do collect themselves, at least momentarily. Brian Willis on the give and into the end zone. High-stepping in there, young man. The Raiders connect on their PAT. They take the 7-6 lead, but special teams really working in the Tigers' favor. Devin Lewis on the kickoff return to the house, young man. 94 yards, a top play nominee. Carver all over the Raiders. 29-7, the final. Del McGee, your thoughts?
The score don't indicate how close the game was. The game was a lot closer than that. I think our defense held when they had to. We bent the whole lot and made a lot of mistakes defensively, but they kept fighting. And Shaw did a good job. They just didn't punch it in when they got close to the red zone. They missed a field goal, and that was kind of costly.
Thank you, guys. Now we come back to the Atlanta area with another early season matchup between the Buford Wolves and the Purple Hurricanes of Cartersville. We go to Tom Ryden Stadium halfway through the first. The handoff to the up back. First man through is Jessel Curry. Nobody touches him, and I mean nobody. 67 yards, and really the only guys to touch him were the same color jerseys when he hit the end zone. 7-0 Buford, late first quarter. Second quarter, now 14-0. The handoff to Tyler King. Leaps over one tackler, gets his feet knocked out from under him at the one. He'd score from there, 21-0. Canes quarterback Donovan Tate hurried all day and all of the night, rolling to his right, throwing one of his four picks on the evening. T.J. Pridemore with the sticky fingers, taking it inside the five-yard line, leading to another score by King. He had two. Demetrius Murray had two scores as well. 38-0 Buford at the half. Let's finish things up with a little defense in the third. The safety in the end zone, 40-0 your final. Buford all over Cartersville. We'll get back to our highlight tour from around the state in a bit, but we slide over to the Diamond to check in on softball. Lowndes High is known for its successful football program around the state, but the fast pitch softball team is making a name for themselves in their 10th season. For the story in Valdosta, we welcome back Eric Hunter.
Back in 1993, schools in DeKalb County and Gwinnett County threw out the first pitch in fast pitch softball. Since then, fast pitch has gradually worked its way east, west, and south to Lowndes High School in talent-rich Valdosta, Georgia. The Vikettes are strong again in 2007 after stumbling to fourth place in Region 1 5A last season, only to go on and tie for fifth in the state tournament. That young squad finished with a flourish, and that team chemistry has carried over to this season.
We've known each other since we're in elementary, and we've always played together. We always work well together.
I like the people and our coaching staff and our parents, how well they support us, and then, I mean, just the fans, all the people that come to the games. I just love the, you know, being at Lowndes High.
And they've got some potent sticks in the lineup. Junior third baseman Morgan Harris led Region 1 in home runs last year with 7 and was the team's top run producer with 23 ribbies. Junior catcher Sarah Santana hit .426 last season with a .564 slugging average. She was also all-region in 06 as a shortstop and has made a big transition this year to leading the team from behind the plate.
You know, I'm a real quiet person, so it's hard to step up and, you know, make decisions and tell everybody what to do. But this year, you know, I've really learned, like, I've become a lot more comfortable with it because I know more of what I'm doing this year. And so I really just try to step it up and, you know, just make sure I know and let everybody know where they're going.
Lauren Revels is the Vikettes' number one pitcher. She had a 1.84 ERA last season, but pitching hasn't always been in her blood.
I started pitching about fifth grade, sixth grade, and I hated it. My parents made me go to pitching lessons. I never thought I'd be a pitcher. I always wanted to play first base or shortstop. But recently, about eighth or ninth grade, I started really loving it. And then I guess here I am.
Lowndes is in their 10th season of fast pitch softball, and during that span, they have won 7 region titles, and they've also made it to the final 8 6 times.
I've been real blessed, and this kind of hits home for me because I'm from Lowndes High School. I graduated from Lowndes High School, and it's nice that a tradition was started when I got here 6 years ago, and we kind of kept it going, and I've been blessed to have a lot of good players, a lot of good support, our booster club, our parents, our fans, you know, the administration works real hard for us, and so we've been real blessed to kind of keep the tradition going.
Look for the winning to continue and the pitching to get faster at Lowndes with a real strong bunch of juniors and only 2 seniors this season. From Valdosta, I'm Eric Hunter for Prep Sports Plus.
Thanks, Eric. And if the Viquettes have their way, they would unseat the current champ up in Woodstock. But the Wolverines might have something to say about that to the rest of 5A by the time we get to Columbus and to South Commons.
That is what a first ever looks like, at least to Woodstock High School. After grabbing the state title in softball last year, a first in any sport for the school.
Y'all, this trophy belongs to everybody. Everybody contributed. You're all team players. You guys are state champs 2006.
And this is what a first ever leads to. A lot more work in 07 if you want to repeat, but a great reminder of what 06 was.
It was winning the title was amazing. I can't really describe it. We worked so hard for it, and when we finally got it, it was just the best feeling.
Now, you see how it looks out there right now? The next time somebody pitches, it definitely will not look the same. One pitching change for the 2007 Wolverines means that 3 players could be moving at any one time to positions that they weren't at last year. And coaches even had 5 different players at catcher this year. But the bottom line is, if something works, something works.
We had our catcher go down, and we had to move our shortstop behind the plate for a few games, which means you have to fill in the shortstop hole, which means you have to fill in. Anyway, it's a vicious cycle. It's like plugging holes in a boat. But everybody's stepping up and learning their role. And we're working the kinks out.
It's really hard because, like, we get really frustrated because people don't know what they're doing. But, we help each other and, we tell them we got them and everything. So, I mean, I'll go from one position to the next, and it gets confusing trying to learn everything. But I'm getting there, and everyone else is too.
The one who hasn't been one of the 5 behind the plate so far this year should be back any day now. Senior Tori Moody is coming off surgery, and I'll leave it up to you to think just how ready she thinks she is.
I am itching to get back, but I know that everything's been okay with Vinay, and, well, things will be different, I guess, because I'll be back in the lineup and everything will get back to normal, but right now, people are just having to step up, and Vinay's doing an awesome job doing that.
Pinching chores in 07 are split this time around. All everything Carrie Chambers has graduated, so the top guns will be seniors Nikki Roddy and Jessica Martin.
Kind of makes me nervous in a way, but I have great defense to back me up. I know it's going to come through. We're going to do good. I feel confident.
It just makes me work that much harder. It makes me, when I'm at home, I practice, and when I'm on the field, I work hard. And I know my defense has got my back no matter what, and I know on offensive they got my back too.
You know, the good thing about Jessica Martin and Nikki Roddy was they were probably capable of pitching for most varsity teams last year. That just wasn't their role. We had them in different roles last year because, of course, we had Chambers. And they're stepping out and trying to prove something themselves, and they're capable of doing it. It's just going to be a matter if we can put the defense behind them and get the bats going.
And through it all, the defending champs are still ranked in the top 10, right now at number 6 in the state in 5A. Now to our Academic Athlete of the Week segment, where we check in on a 3 sports star that looks to be something to his peers now and something for his family later on in life. For the story in Toccoa, here's Lisa Weiss.
When it comes to academic athletes, Torin Poole is the creme de la creme. He plays 3 sports at Stevens High School. He has been an honor roll student for the past 3 years, and he currently carries a 3.75 GPA.
I take every class serious. I just feel like that's important in life. And I see those guys, great talent. I mean, amazing talent, but they just don't have the grades. And I just told myself I wasn't going to be like that. I was going to be better than that. And I've accomplished that so far, and I ain't going to stop.
He's an excellent student. He's also a wonderful young man, very well behaved, very polite. I see great things for him in the future.
He's the epitome of what a high school athlete truly is because he's a great player. He works hard in the offseason, and he's a great student.
Poole stays busy year-round with track, basketball, and football, yet he still finds the time to inspire others as a volunteer mentor at the Boys and Girls Club.
It's all about the young kids, just letting them realize that a lot of things are important in life, you know, not just what seems to say friends, you know, school is important. I mean, sports are important, but, you know, school is more important.
Torrance's passion lies on the gridiron, where he applies the same work ethic he does in every aspect of his life, and it has paid off. Last year, Poole rushed for over 1,900 yards with 24 touchdowns and helped lead the Indians to a 10-2 record. This year, he wants to do even more.
I'm just trying to reach another goal past 1,900 yards. Yeah, that's a lot of yards, but I just feel like goals are reachable, you know, if you just attain that hard work mentality.
A great athlete. I mean, just runs over everybody. I mean, it's just it's a weapon to have.
He has great hands. He can catch the ball. He's big and strong, and he gets a lot of yards after contact. So I think he's a special running back, but I think by him being a special person is what makes him a special player.
When it comes to student athletes, it doesn't get much better than Torrance Poole. Not only is he one of the top running backs in the state, he was smart enough to realize that it takes more than just talent to make it to the next level. So he decided to apply himself in the classroom as well. And because of that, he was able to reach his ultimate goal.
Getting, you know, 7 scholarships from Division I A schools, I think that's the greatest accomplishment that I could ever accomplish.
Poole has narrowed his offers down to Tennessee and South Carolina. Once in college, he wants to major in business, and he has his sights set on playing in the NFL.
Just felt like that if I work, anything is possible. So my mom told me that. You know, she told me to always believe in God. You know, I've been doing that ever since. You know, nothing's going to change. I'm always going to believe, and that's how I've got here so far.
In Toccoa, I'm Lisa Weiss reporting for Prep Sports Plus.
Thank you, Lisa. Some big games in the Atlanta area, including a huge region rivalry in Quad A. Here's your highlights. Thanks, as always, to our friends from CBS 46. First to Adams Stadium, Druid Hills, Red Devils taking on the Panthers of Carver in maroon. Number 24, Damon Dennis, cutting right in front of you, 60 yards for the score. Later, it's quarterback Tionte Little to Dante Smith with the big gainer, the fade route, and the quick six. Carver wins big, 45-0 over Druid Hills. Next stop, Northcutt Stadium, the Marietta Blue Devils hosting the Kell Longhorns in their white and burnt orange threads. Kell driving back to pass, and what a lick by Marietta's Devin Floyd. Later on, Kell moving again. The run goes nowhere up the middle. Chris Tansey with the strip, and he takes off the other way. 70 yards for the touchdown, and it wouldn't be Friday without Friday Richards. Blue Devils win it 42-9. Now to Panthersville Stadium. The Redan Raiders in white taking on MLK in red. The Raiders with the interception, 70 yards for the score the other way. And watch the finish for Justin Moore. He'll almost stick the landing, but MLK squeaks it out, 14-13. And finally, a big six Quad A matchup at Hallford Stadium. Tucker and Marist. The Tigers adding to their early lead. The toss pitch to Derek Harris. He squeezes in to make it 13-0. Tucker shuts out Marist 30-0. We kick in the highlight tour once more, heading down to Savannah with WJCL-TV sports director Frank Sulkowski with his look at two games, MCA and Cavalry Day, and ECI and Trutland County.
McIntosh County Academy paying a visit to Calvary. Bucks up big in the third quarter, looking for more. Jeremy Height makes a nice grab for a McIntosh first down. However, three plays later, they're going to turn it over. Bucks back to pass. Bubba Green coming in for the interception for the Calvary Cavaliers. Celebration, though, would be short-lived for the home team. They're going to give it right back. Trace Thornton throws downfield. Manny Evans is there for the interception. Number four returning it 20 yards for the touchdown. McIntosh went up 42-0 at that point. And that's your final, 42-0 from Calvary. Meanwhile, over in Twin City, Trutland County paying a visit to ECI. Bulldogs up 2-0 in the first half, adding to their lead. Here's Sanquez Lee scoring. That's 9-0. A botched kickoff gave the Dogs good field position. And again, they're getting into the end zone. This time it's Brooks Kirkland with the extra point. It was 16-0 ECI. How about to the second quarter now? ECI in business again. Washon Ely dodging tacklers. He's going to make a run for the corner. He dives, and he is in for six more. ECI rolls over Trutland, 51-7, the final. In Savannah, Frank Sulkowski, Prep Sports Plus.
Thank you, Frank. Time now for our statewide top fives, courtesy of our friends at the GACA. There was some shifting and shaking in the polls, as we reveal them to you right now. Starting in single A, this should look very familiar. ECI, Wilcox County, Lincoln County, Athens Academy, and Seminole County are your 1-5. We check in on life in Donaldsonville in 2 weeks. In AA, Charlton County takes out Andrew Jackson High of Florida. You saw Buford's win over Cartersville to keep them in step. Calhoun slides out after a loss to Villarica. The Purple Hurricane of Fitzgerald and Early County slide up to 3-4. Dodge County is your new number 5 after a big win against Hawkinsville. AAA. 1 and 2 are LaGrange and Carver Columbus. Carrollton is now your 3. North Hall slips in at 4 after shutting out Pickens, and Hart stays at 5 after getting their first win of the season. Quad A has a little movement. Northside Warner Robins takes out neighbor Warner Robins to stay on top. 2 and 3 remain the Wolves and the Yellow Jackets. You saw Tucker's win over Marist that puts them in and takes the War Eagles out. Griffin is your new number 5. And in 5A, it's the same for your first 4. Roswell, Norcross, Tipp County, and Coffee County. The Rams from Grayson are on the bottom of the page after taking out the Ridge. Now to our cream of the crop segment. One guy's dad was called the Hammer, and the other guy simply brings the heat. One guy's played for 10 years, the other for about 10 games. These Titans never clash, and that's a good thing. In Alpharetta, here's Gerald Oliveri.
This week's cream of the crop comes from Northview High School. The Titans have over 30 seniors on this year's team. On the offensive side of the ball, the leader for the team is senior quarterback Justin Tuggle, son of Hall of Fame linebacker Jesse the Hammer Tuggle.
He's got a cannon of an arm. He has a good touch on the short stuff. He can scramble as well as anybody in the state. He does it all. He's the complete package.
When Justin first started playing football, like his father, he played on the defensive side of the ball. He played linebacker and he even tried playing safety. But in the end, he decided that it was more fun scoring touchdowns than stopping them.
It is more fun on offense. You get to control the game, they keep the defense guessing. They don't know what's going on, so I like being in control.
On the football field, he wanted to excel. He wanted to be the best person on the football field, and I think that's what motivated him. He wanted to go out there and show people that he's the best, you know, regardless of what his last name is. He wanted to go out there and prove to people each and every Friday night that he wanted the best in the state.
Next season, Justin will embark upon a new challenge when he moves on to Boston College. But for now, he's focused on helping his team improve upon last season's 5-5 record, which was the best in school history. In order to do that, the Titans are going to need senior defensive tackle Cordian Hagans to be the anchor for the defense again. Last season, he helped lead the Titans with 56 tackles, 7 of them for a loss, and he also had 3 sacks.
Believe it or not, 2006 was actually the first year that Cordian even played football. He had been a basketball player for the last couple of years, and his friend Justin had been trying to convince him to come out and play with the team. Well, last year he did so, and it turned out to be a good decision for everybody.
You're too big to play in basketball. You're 6'6", point guard 6'8" in the NBA. You got a better chance of football, so he came out here and listened to me, thank God.
The thing I had to get used to was, like, just getting used to the heat outside. And I was used to being in air-conditioning places all the time, and, you know, it's really hard to make that adjustment.
At 6'5", 295 pounds, Cordian's size, along with his incredible strength, was a great addition to the team. Although this is only his second season of playing football, Cordian's immense natural talent has definitely been seen by everyone.
And he's a heck of a football player. He come a long way. From a kid who naturally was gifted with good footwork, and you can, when a guy's that big and have great footwork, you know he can play football.
There's nothing that he cannot do. I know he's gotten good coaching, you know, last year and this year, but he gets to LSU and is around, you know, experts in the field and college football coaches that can, you know, he can eat at their training table and be in their weight room. You know, again, the sky is the limit for him. He has the largest upside of any kid I've coached.
Reporting for Prep Sports Plus, I'm Gerald Oliveri, and that's what's going on at Northview High School.
Justin said his father's laid a few hits on him when they practice in the backyard, but he claims they didn't hurt. Thank you, Gerald. For us, it's the bottom of the ninth inning, but before we go, we just wanted to show you something. The champs of the Little League World getting their just rewards at home. We go back to the International City one last time. The estimated crowd of 2,000 inside the Homer Walker Civic Center were witness to the team getting keys to the city and a check to help defray the cost of the trip to Williamsport. Governor and Warner Robins Little League All-Star Sonny Perdue congratulated the team for the win and told them that while the final against Japan was an event, it was a process that got them there.
With the compassion, with the sportsmanship, all those things just didn't happen. What you saw on the field was a reflection of the values of Middle Georgia as put forth through the parents and volunteers, the coaches and the managers. So thank you, guys.
As I got up this morning, I said, what better way to represent our league, our country, and these individuals behind me? And the reason this, I trust in God, I love my country, and will respect its laws. I will play fair and strive to win. But win or lose, I will always do my best.
Congratulations to all of you, and welcome home. Next week on Prep Sports Plus, we visit with one of Georgia's football coaching greats back in his hometown of Eatonton. We check in on the reigning AAA softball champs, and we meet one of the state's leaders in all-purpose yardage. I'm on my last page of copy, so that means only one thing. We're out of time. On behalf of everyone at Prep Sports Plus, thanks for watching Georgia Public Broadcasting. And remember, if you have some extra time, catch a high school sport. Play safe, everybody. We'll see you next time.
Watching Prep Sports Plus, brought to you in part by
Wachovia. Helps our customers stay informed about important issues by supporting GPB. We see it as an essential part of our commitment to serve our growing state. With hundreds of financial centers and ATMs in Georgia, Wachovia can help you realize your financial goals.
As a proud sponsor of the Georgia High School Association, Georgia's electric membership corporations provide reliable electricity and service, not only to our communities, but to the athletes within them. Georgia's electric membership corporations, lighting the way.
The Georgia Student Finance Commission. Now students can plan, apply, and pay for colleges in Georgia on one website. GACollege411.org.
And by viewers like you.
This has been a production of Georgia Public Broadcasting.